I think based on all the data that we have seen from the first line trials, that chemo and immunotherapy combination is not better than chemotherapy alone, and single agent immunotherapy did not work better than gemcarbo and cisplatin ineligible patients. I would say that in June 2021, we should be offering platinum-based chemotherapy to all first-line metastatic urothelial cancer patients, and only a minor subset of truly platinum-ineligible patients who cannot even receive carboplatin should we be offering single-agent pembro or atezo as initial therapy. When patients are offered first-line platinum-based chemotherapy for both cis-eligible patients, being gem-cis or MVAC, for cis-ineligible patients, it would be gem-carbo. If patients progress on that, then any of the approved checkpoint inhibitors can be offered. And I want to make a note that atezolizumab and durvalumab have been withdrawn in the U.S. So depending on where one is and what checkpoint inhibitors are available, they should be offered at progression. If patients have stable disease or a response, then avelumab maintenance should be offered to these patients based on the JAVELIN Bladder 100 data. And upon further progression, there are options like antibody drug conjugates and fostamatinib vedotin, sacituzumab govitecan, or the FGFR inhibitor erdafitinib for select patients. Yes, so for the FGFR inhibitor is requiring molecular testing only for patients who have FGFR3 alterations or fusions or mutations benefit from that. But other than that, for the antibody drug conjugates, we do not have any guiding biomarkers. With the recent approval of sacituzumab govitecan, showing promise in prior platinum and immunotherapy treated patients, that is promising with the recent accelerated approval. As far as newer agents, there are several intratumoral agents in development, which, along with systemic immunotherapy, look promising, like the mRNA, TLR7/8 agonists, and other agents on the horizon.